Hello, this is Major 12, as you know. This is going to be what we call your popular tutorial of how to put text onto a map the easy way. The proper way where you need to use some of your view of it and then the proper way where you use Cinema 4D and Vuju, movies, hard to use programs, is a lot more complicated. This is going to be an easier way. What does look good if you take the time on it? I didn't spend too much time on this, but it still came out looking okay. I'm happy with it. I'll probably work on this a bit longer if I was actually going to put it in a montage thing. But if you practice and fiddle around with it, I think you'll get. Now I'm just going to go straight into this now. I'm going to put on draft filter just to show you what it's going to look like. Probably something like that. But that's probably the worst quality. I'm going to show you. And even if you have a dazzle quality, which I do have, it comes out looking great because you... There's a screenshot. It's basically... it's going off. So I'm going to start a new project. Yes, I'm going to show you how to start project actually. Actually, I'm not going to show you. But I'm not going to. No. So I'm going to show you how I start a new project each time. New project. I always have it at 1080p. Okay? Width 1080 and height 720. And then what I do is I put the pixel format at 32-bit. If you have a 64-bit version of Sonyvegas, you should use that. But my computer only runs on... My laptop only runs on a 32-bit operating system. You want the compositing gamma at the linear. Full resolution rendering quality at best. And motion blur type at Gaussian. You probably start all projects in these settings. And then you just click OK. Okay, now, to start this off, I'm not sure if I'm going to put these over two parts, because it might take a little longer. This is how it works. You need to get. You basically need to go up into any map you want. Make sure you probably want to put your text on a flat surface on the map. That'll be wise. You want to, don't move at all. I guess, if you watch this and you, watch carefully, of how I show you motion tracking in this, you'll be able to pick up if you can do a moving one, so it goes around your text. It could be possible, I think it's possible. I'll try it. If it doesn't come out well, I'll tell you in my next update. But yeah, first what you have to do is you get your clip in, get where you want it to start. I want it right there. Nope, yeah, yes, I kept it staying still. I'm going to right click it, go to properties, maintain aspect ratio and disable the resample. So it's full screen. Now I'm going to split that. And here, up here, it says save snapshot for file. I'm going to click that. And you can save it wherever you want it to be, but I really just click save anywhere. Because I have never found it again before, and it automatically comes up into your project's media. I'm going to drag this in. I think you only need about 3 tracks to do this whole thing. You just delete this stuff, I don't need it. Yeah, you only need 3 tracks. It's pretty good. Yeah, what you want to do from here, when you got your... have your screenshot, you want to go to event pan crop. I'll show you it in this one. Click here. And then you want to go to the corner. Make sure you click on the top bar, because then this bottom bar here is masked. You don't want to mask anything in this. Unless you're doing something which is not what you're doing. And click on the first keyframe here, and you're going to drag it in so spectating is out of it, out of the equation. You just want to say that in the commentary. Thank you. To get this, if you don't know how to record animatics, you want to go to get your map, but when you set the game, you want to make sure you put the spectating on free and make sure it's on hardcore mode as enabled, so all that stuff, funky stuff and the parts and stuff will come up. And then you don't do anything yourself. When you go in, you just press start, and then you'll, well, that's if it's on PS3, then you just go into spectating mode. It has a black line because it's undraft water. If it's the best ball, it will be gone. So, yeah, so that's not for the first part. You can even put on best or best throw. So for, what I'm gonna do? I'm wasting a lot of time. I probably have to do this over two parts. And grab this one. I'm gonna make a bit new video track. And you want to make sure this is on the bottom. Then on the top one, you right click and go insert text media. And the type of note as well. This is the text I want there. Do what you want. Call your name, or the name that's what you're doing. And then I'm going to make the text a lot smaller. I think it works well for this clip at 40. That's what I'm going to do. Make sure you make an appropriate size for what you're doing. Yeah, just get the text. Oh, I'm going to color it as well. I'm going to, you can color it as well. If you go to media generate, it's the same thing you're on. And go to properties, you can color it. This is based, if you don't know how to use these, okay, it's basically red, green, and blue. Primary colors. Just, even if you drag these two down, you make green. If I drag this one up, you make blue. If I drag these two down, you make a dark blue. If you drag this one down, and then this one up, you get a red. So, it's pretty simple. So I want to make red text this time. Okay. Close it down, and then what you want to do here is you want to see on the track where your text is. You want to go to compositing mode, click, and go to 3D source alpha. You basically want to move the text around in the 3D space, basically. And go to track motion. I think, yeah, on this you're moving around the Y axis, I think. One positive. What I want to do, no, before I do that, I'm going to go to Vampire Clock. I'm going to move this into basically just on top of the thing. That's what she said. So it's in the right position. That's what she said again. For me to start twisting it. I am saying so many really bad innuendos. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm just going to move it into the right position. Or what's up with this lag? It's just moving around somewhere. About there. So I want the text to be about there. Up a bit more actually. Ah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, about that's fine. And then, we do just make sure you put on a first keyframe when you do that. And then I'm going to X out of that and go to track motion. Now I'm going to type in on the Y axis. Basically, you can just like move this around. If you're going to do this, flips it upside down. That is the Z axis. If I this is the X axis. You can also use to flip stuff around to the Y axis. Okay, I'm going to put this all in 0 then.